Welcome back everyone, my name is Abdullah Ghori from Alpha Technology, and in this video we are gonna be creating a quiz game in C++. So in this game we'll ask question from user, then we'll provide four options and user have to select any of these options, and then we'll check the answer, is it correct or wrong. If the answer is correct, then we'll increase the number of correct answer by one. If the answer is wrong, then we'll increase the number of wrong answer by one. Okay, so we'll also display the number of questions, correct answers, and the number of wrong answer as well. Before we get started, I want to show you that on our channel Alpha Technology, we are continuously uploading C++ programming tutorials, so you can watch and learn C++ programming from them. So make sure to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so you get notification about all the upcoming videos. So without any further delay, let's start writing code. So first of all, we need to declare three variables. So our first variable will be int, integer variable, which is question number, in which we store the number of question. So initially the question number will be 1. After that we'll create another integer variable which is correct. So in this variable we store the number of correct answer, and we'll also create a variable wrong, and in this we'll store the number of wrong answer. After that we'll create functions. So because this video is a part of functional programming in C++, so you will get better understanding of functions and arguments and parameters, that how they are work in C++ programming. And other thing is that all the question will be random. So whenever user start the game, the question will arrive in the random. So here we'll create a function which is void display random question. So this function will make sure that every time user start the game, their questions are picking up in the random order or shows in the random order. So after that we create a function void display. In this function will display question number, correct answer, and wrong answer. After that we'll create a void question function. So in this function we'll pass 5 arguments. So first argument will be string question, which will be our question, and then we'll also pass option A, option B, and option C, option D, and at the last we'll pass a character variable which is correct answer. So in this variable we'll pass, in this argument we'll pass that which option is correct, is it A, B, or C, or D. After that we'll create another function which will be our void result. So this function will show the result at the end of the game. Okay, so another variable which we need to create is our boolean variable. So bool ask, which will be an array of boolean, of 10 boolean, and here we'll store 10 true values. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 boolean array will check that which question was asked and which question is remaining to be asked. So first of all here we'll create our void display function. So we'll say void display, and here we'll say system cls. It will make sure that our screen is clear. This is not a best way to clear the screen, but it will work for beginners. So here we'll say question number, QUES question number, and here we'll type our question number variable. After that we'll type to tab, and here we'll say correct answer. So here we'll show our correct variable and we'll also show wrong answers. And here we'll type our wrong variable and inline, and we want that we'll put two inlines. Okay, now that's look good. After that we'll call our display random function. So we'll say display random question. So first of all we are displaying question number, correct answers and wrong answer. After that we are displaying the question. Okay, so let's create our display random function, random question function as well. So we'll say void display random questions, and here first of all we need to get a random number. So to generate a random number we need to include some header files which is include random, and another file header file will be include ctime. So these two header file will be needed to create or generate a random number. Now we'll set the random number. So we'll say srand, and here we'll pass time 0. So it will make sure that the random number which is generated is totally random. After that we'll set a boolean is question remaining. So initially we'll initialize this variable by false, and here we'll check that is the questions are remaining or not. So we'll run a for loop int I equal to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus, and here we'll say if ask of I, if ask of I means it will iterate from ask of 0 to ask of 9. So it will check if ask array having a true value. So we'll set our is question remaining variable by true, and we'll break our loop. So it will make sure that there is at least one question is remaining in our question array. So here we'll say while, we'll run a while loop and we'll say is question remaining, and now we'll create int num variable which will store a random number. So we'll say rand mod 10, so that will make sure that the random number that we'll get will be from 0 to 9. So here we'll say if ask of num, if ask of number, that means that the question we are asking from user, if it is having a true value then we'll ask the question, because whenever we ask any question then we'll set the number of this question as false. So it will make sure that every time we ask a question is different from the previous. So here we'll say switch, first we'll set our ask of num value to false, so it will make sure that next time will doesn't ask this same question. So here we'll say ask switch num, and here we'll put our cases. So we'll say case 0, in case 0 we'll call our question function, and here we'll pass the question. So our first question we are typing a random question, so we'll say which language supports the object oriented programming technique. Okay, so here we'll provide the options. So we'll say C language and C++ language, COBOL language, Fortran language. And last, we'll pass the correct option. So our correct option will be C++, so it is B. So we'll say B. After that, we'll type break here, so it will break the question or the switch block. And here we'll type our second case, so we'll say case 1. And here we'll call our question function again. So here we'll say what is a variable, and here we'll pass the option, so we'll say empty container in which we store data. Box data type. So I don't have any question in mind, so I am typing these useless questions, so don't worry about that. So here we'll say language, and we'll pass the right answer, so in this case it will be A. And here we'll type our break statement. So instead of wasting time in typing this question, because you have your different questions, so I will just copy paste this question, so we can save your variable times. So 6, 8, 10, I think these are 10. So let me change the numbers of these. So question 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay, so these are our 9 question. So let me add numbers, so we can check that every time the question are shows to user are random. At the last, we'll call our result function. So because we are here, we are checking that if the question is remaining, then it will ask the question, and if the question is not remaining, so it should show the result to user. So we'll call our result function. And at the last, let me just create our result function. So here we'll say void result. First of all, we'll need to clear the screen, so we'll say systemcls. After that, we'll show that total question. So we'll say total questions are equal to, and here we'll say question number minus 1. And after that, we'll say inline, and here we'll say correct answers is equal to our correct variable. And here we'll type wrong answers is equal to our wrong variable. And here we'll check the result, we'll show the result as well. So we'll say if correct is greater than wrong, then so we'll say cout. Result is equal to pass and inline. Else if wrong is greater than correct, if the number of wrong questions are greater than the number of correct question, so we'll say cout, result equal to fail and inline. Else if correct answer are not greater than wrong answer and wrong answer are not greater than correct answer, that means these are equal. So here we'll say C out. Result equal to tie. So this function will show the results. So the last function that we need to create is our question function. So we'll say void question, and here we'll say a string question. String A, string B, these are our arguments, string C, string D, and at the last our character variable, which is correct answer. So now here we'll say C out, our question variable. So whatever the question we are showing, that after that we'll say C out A, and here let me add a tab so it will be separated. So here we'll say A, C out option B slash T, here we'll say B and inline C out option C slash T and C, whatever present in our C variable, last D slash T and C out D and inline. After that we'll create a character answer variable in which we store the correct answer, and we'll ask the user to answer the question, and we'll store the answer of user in our answer variable. So here we'll say if answer equal to correct answer, that we are passing here, if this value that we pass is equal to the value that user select, then we'll say correct variable plus plus. Okay, else, and here we'll say if this is not equal, then we'll say wrong plus plus, and at the end we'll say question number plus plus. So we also increase the number of questions as well. So let me call our display function. So after displaying every question, it will call the display function, and now I think our game is created. So let me build and run this program. Oh, there is a mistake. So here the variable name is wrong in capital letters. So now let me build and run this program again. Sorry, in our main function we need to call these functions as well. So here we just need to call our display function, and let me show how that will work. So here we are calling our display function. Now display function will clear the screen and show the question number and correct answer and wrong answer, and after that it will call display random questions. So display random question will, what it will do, it will generate a random number, and that it will check that is the question is asked previously or not. If not, then it will ask this question, and then we are here in switch block, it will get the question, any of these. So it will run until we are getting a question that is never asked before, and here after asking the question in our question, so here we are calling our display function again. So it will call this function, and this function will call display random function. So this thing will go until we ask all the question. If there is no question remaining, then it will call our result function, and this result function will execute and show the result to us. So now let me build and run this program and see how this quiz game is working. So there we go. So this is our game. So it is question number 5 that we have inserted, but actually it is question number 1, but the question that it gets is question number 5. So let me say that option A is correct. So let me hit enter, because the answer is wrong. So the wrong number of wrong answer is increased by 1 and correct answer is 0. So now it is showing us question number 7. So let me answer this time correct. So here you can see that correct answer is increased by 1 and wrong answer is 0, and this is question number 3. So now it is calling 9th questions. So here we'll say D, C, B, A. So you can see that every time the question arise are totally random. So is question number 7, and there you can see correct answer are only 2. So now you can see the result as well. Total questions that are asked are 10, correct answer are 4, and sorry, wrong answer are 6, not wrong answer, and result is fail. So let me correct this. This is wrong answer. And now let me run this program and check if we pass the test, then if this is showing that you are pass or not. So we'll say B, A, B, A, B, A, A. So here we give 8 correct answers, so it is saying pass. So now let me check for the tie as well. So here we'll say A, A, B, 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 and now you can see 5 wrong answer and 5 right answer, and result is tie. So that's how you can build a quick quiz game in C++ programming using functions. So I hope that you get better understanding of function, that how functions works in C++, how we can use the random number generator in our real world problems. And I think you will also get the idea of using Boolean variables and arrays, how arrays works, how function calling works, and everything. So here you can replace the question whatever you want. And also if you want to get the questions from a file, you can get as well.
Welcome back everyone, my name is Abdullah Ghori from Alpha Technology, and in this video we'll create rock paper scissors game in C++. So before we get started, make sure to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so you don't miss any new video. So let's start writing code. So first of all, we need to declare some variables. So our first variable will be string name, or we can say player name, in which we store the name of the player. So we'll say cout. We are printing a message to user that enter your name, and we'll store the player name in our player name variable. So we'll say cin player name. After that, we want that our screen should be clear, so we'll say system, and in the system function we'll pass the argument cls, so it will clear the screen for us. So here we'll declare another variables rounds, in which we store the rounds, and we ask the user that how many rounds do you want to play. So we'll say player name, how many rounds you want to play, and we'll store the rounds in our rounds variable. So we'll say rounds, and here we'll declare two other variables. The first one is player score, the second one is computer score. So we'll say int player score equal to 0. So our player score will be 0, and computer score equal to 0. So we are creating two variables, player score and computer score, and we are initializing the player score and computer score with 0. After that, we need to run a loop that will run rounds time, or we can say that will run the number of time that user enter. So we'll say for int round equal to 1, round less than or equal to rounds that user enter, round plus plus, and here we'll say system cls. It will clear the screen for us, and after that we need to declare two other variables. The first one is player choice and second one is computer choice. So we'll say player choice comma computer choice, and here we'll display the round number and the player and computer score. So we'll say cout. Round number, round of rounds. So let's say user enter 5 in the rounds variable. So it will print that round number 1 of 5. So that's great. So after that, we'll print the scores. So we'll say player name's score. So whatever the player name, it will say the player name's score equal to, and here we'll print the player score variable. So we'll say player score inline, and we'll print another message for computer score. So we'll say computer score is equal to computer score variable and inline. After that, we'll print the choices to user, that 1 equal to rock, 2 equal to paper, 3 equal to scissor, and after that we'll print that select your choice. So we'll say cout 1 for rock, cout 2 for paper and inline, cout 3 for scissor and inline. And after that we say the user that select your choice, and we'll store the choice of the user in player choice variable. So now we have the player choice. So we need computer choice, but we want that the computer choice should be random. So how can we make a program that will generate some random numbers? So I have a separate video on this topic, so you can watch and learn from it. I will drop the link in the description section below. So to create or to generate the random numbers, we need to include some other header files. So we'll say include. The first header file will be stdlib.h, and the other header file will be ctime. So these two header files needs to generate some random numbers. So here we'll say srand, that means set the rand. And in srand we'll pass the argument time or function time, and in function we'll pass the argument 0. So it will set the random number with our time. So it will make sure that all the random number are generated that are perfectly random. So after that we'll say computer choice equal to rand. This is a function that returns some random numbers, and we'll say mod 3. It will make sure that the random numbers that are returned by rand function are from 0 to 2, but we want the random number from 1 to 3, so we'll say plus 1 at the last. So now it will return the random number from 1 to 3. So after that we'll check the condition. So we'll say if. Now if player choose 1 and computer choose 3, that mean player wins. So we'll say if player choice equal to 1 and computer choice equal to 3, that means if player choose rock and computer choose scissor, that means our player wins. So we'll say cout player win and here we'll increase the score of the player by 1. So we'll say player score plus plus, and we'll check another condition. So we'll say else if player choice equal to 2 and computer choice. Now player choice equal to 2, that means player choice equal to paper, and computer choice equal to 1, that means computer choice equal to rock. So in this case again our player will win, so we'll say cout player win, and at the last we'll say inline, and here we'll increase the score of the player by 1. So we'll say player score plus plus, we'll say else if. So we'll check another condition. So we'll say player score, player choice, if player choice equal to 3 and computer choice equal to 2, that means our player wins. So we'll say cout player win, and here we'll increase the score of the player by 1. So we'll say player score plus plus, and after that we'll check another condition for draw. So we'll say if player choice equal to computer choice, that means it's a draw. So we'll say cout draw, and else. So now if the round is not draw or not player winning, so we'll say that computer wins. So we'll say cout computer win inline. After that we'll increase the score of the computer by 1. So we'll say computer score plus plus. Now there is a small bug. If player doesn't use 1, 2 or 3, that means our program will say computer wins. So we don't want that. So here we'll run a do while loop that will make sure that the user selects the number from 1 to 3, nothing else. So we'll say, so we'll cut this part here from, and we'll paste in the do block, and here we'll type a condition that while player choice not equal to 1 and player choice not equal to 2 and player choice not equal to 3. So now our program will run perfectly fine. At the last we just need to print that who is going to win. So after the for block we'll say if computer score equal to player score, so we'll say cout game is drawn inline, else if player score greater than computer score. So now we'll say cout player name you won the game and else cout computer won the game. So now let me build and run this program and see how our program will work. So we'll say build and run. So this is our program. So it is saying that enter your name. So we'll say alpha. So it is saying that alpha, how many rounds do we want to play? So we'll say 5 rounds I want to play. So it is showing that round number 1 of 5, alpha score is 0, computer score 0, and here it is printing them, select 1 for rock, 2 for paper, 3 for scissors. So we'll select 1. So now our program works fine, but the last thing is that it is not showing the results. Now we have to say that press any key to continue, and we'll have to stop the results until user press any key. So we'll say cout press any key to continue. And at the last we'll say getch. So this getch function comes in the header file conio.h, so we'll include the header file, so we'll say include conio.h. so if we now run this program, this will works fine. So let's enter our name alpha, and it is saying alpha, how many rounds do we want to play? So we'll say we want to play 5 rounds. So now let's select number 1. So you can see there it is showing the results, that is draw, and it is saying that press any key to continue. So I'll say enter. Let's select 2. So we won 3, computer 1, 4, and draw. So in this case the computer wins. So it is saying that computer won the game.
Welcome back everyone, my name is Abdullah Ghori from Alpha Technology, and in this video we will create tic-tac-toe game in C++. In this video I will explain the whole logic of tic-tac-toe game, and I will explain how you can create this game by your own. I will explain everything step by step so you can learn everything from this video. And there is another interesting thing in this game. In this game we will implement two modes of this game. In the first mode, user and computer can play the game, and in the second mode, two players can play this game. So before we get started, if you are new on this channel, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so you get notification whenever we upload any new video. So let's start our video. So first of all, we need some variables in which we store the temporary data. Now the first variable will be our board. So we want to create an array of characters in which we store our board. So now let's create character array. So we'll say character board, and here the size of the array will be 9, because in the tic-tac-toe game we have 9 position to be marked. And initially what I will do, I will initialize all the elements as space. So I will copy this 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So we have 9 characters out there. Now what I will do, I will create a function, and the name of the function will be void show board. Now this function will show the board on the screen. Okay, now let's do everything step by step. Now let's go down and first implement the show board method so we can see how our board will look like. So what I will do, I will go down, and here we will implement our show board method. We'll say void show board. It will not accept any argument, so here we will print the board on the console screen. So we'll say cout, and after that I will print 3 spaces there, 1 2 3, and after that I will say 1 2 3 4 spaces, then a pipe sign, and 1 2 3 spaces right there. After that what I will do, I will add 4 more spaces, 1 2 3 4, and a pipe sign, and 1 2 3 spaces. After that here I will say inline. So we have created first line of our board. So after that I will go down, I will say cout, and here I will say 1 2 3 spaces. After 3 spaces I will print the first character of the board, so I will say board of 0. Okay, so after that I will print 4 spaces, and then I will print a pipe sign, then 3 spaces. After that I will print board of 1, so the second character of the board, and here I will print 4 spaces, and then a pipe sign, and then 3 spaces. After that I will print board of 2, which is the third character of our board. Now let's see how our board will look like. So what I will do, I will call this show board method here, I will run this code, and you can see this is the output, but it's not look great. So what we need to do here, we need to erase one space, and we need to erase the one space from here as well. I will save this code, I will run this code. Now everything looks fine there. We can copy these two statements and then we can paste them here and we can paste them here. Now we just need to replace the index number of the board. Now here we have board of 0 at the top right here, board of 1 here, board of 2 here. Here we'll say board of 3, then board of 4, board of 5, board of 6, board of 7 and board of 8. Now I will save this code. Let me build and run this program and see. So it looks fine for now. Now what we need to do, we need to add some spaces or some lines there. We need to add some horizontal line. So line will look like this. Okay. So now what we can do, we will come down here. We will add a cout statement. So we will say cout and here we add hyphens. Okay. Now let's try to add these hyphens. If I run this code, it's look like this. I have adjusted the spaces, so you can adjust the space. Now let me describe how many spaces are there. There are 3 spaces. Then 3 spaces are here and 3 here. And then 3 spaces and 3 spaces. After that, 3 spaces are here. And then there are 2 and 3 spaces and 2 and 3 spaces. After that, you can copy these two statements and you can paste them right here. And you can paste the same statement right here. You just need to change the index number of the board. After that, there are some hyphen signs. So let me count how many hyphens are there. 20 hyphens out there. So if I save this code, if I run this program, so you can see our board looks great. Now let's see if we mark any position, is it looks fine or not. So I am marking 2 positions and I will run this code. You can see it looks fine. Okay, but it's not 100% fine. So what I will do, I will copy this statement. I will paste it right here and I will go down. I will paste the statement right here and we can go down. We can put this statement right here as well. So now it will be 100% beautiful board. Now we got our board. Now let's talk about the other things that we need to create. Now here we need to add some methods that we need in our program. So the method will be void get x player. So it will get the x player choice. So this method will get the choice from the x player. X means the player which have the symbol x. After that, we will do the same thing for the o player. So I will copy and paste this and I will say o. So we have 2 methods right there, 2 functions right there. After that, we need another thing that our program will have 2 modes. In the first mode, they have computer and player. And in the second mode, there are 2 players. So let's get the choice for the computer as well. So we'll say get computer choice. So here we will get the computer choice. After that, we need a method or function which will count the board. So here we'll create int count board function and it will accept a character which will be the symbol that it will count in the board. Okay. After that, we have check winner function. So we need to define the check winner. So we'll say void check winner. This function will check the winner. And another thing is that this function will be character because it will return the character. If x win, it will return x. If o win, it will return o. Now after that, we have 2 game modes. The first is void computer vs player, in which computer and player will play the game. And we have another method which is player versus player. So if I say methods, you can assume that I am saying function because I also make the tutorials for the object oriented programming. So that's why it's become my habit to call functions as methods. Now what I will do, let's just go down and first get the choice from the computer. So here I will implement the method. I will say void get computer choice. Now this function will get the computer choice. Now the computer choice will be random. Now we will generate a random number between 0 to 9 and whatever number computer generate, it will be marked the position. So if you don't know about how to generate random numbers, you can watch my video random number generator on my channel, so you can get the idea how we generate the random numbers. Now for that, what I will do, I will go at the top because we need some header files to declare there. So we will include a header file which is C time and another header file which is random. I will go down in the get computer choice function. Here we will say srand. Srand means it will set the random, and I will pass their time, and then in the time I will pass 0. So it will make sure that every time we get the 100% random number. After that I will say int choice. So let's get the computer choice right there. Now we will use a do while loop to make sure that computer gets a random choice which is available. Like in our board, maybe first position is marked and computer also choose the first position. So we'll say there, this position is not available, you need to take another position. Okay, so for that, what we will use, we will use a do while loop which will validate the choice of the computer. So here we will say do. In the block of do, we will say choice is equal to rand. It's a function which will return rand. Percentage 10, it means it will return a random number between 0 to 9. Okay. After that, here we'll come, we'll say while. Now here we'll put our condition. I will say while board of choice. So whatever index number returned by computer, if the index number of, if the position is not equal to an empty space, then the loop will run. Okay. If the position will equal to an empty space, the loop will stop and it will get the choice. After that, we will say board of choice is equal to O, because computer character will always O. Okay. So that's why whatever we get the choice, we are marking in the position with character O. Got it? Now let's move on and let's declare the function which is void get x player choice, in which we get the player choice for the x. Now what I will do here, I will use a while loop. So I will say while true, this loop will run forever until we specify a break statement inside this loop. Now let's see how we specify a break condition. So first of all, I will print that cout select your position, and here I will specify 1 to 9. So it will remind the user that you need to select the position from 1 to 9. After that, what I will do, I will say int choice. So I am declaring a variable called choice in which we store the choice for the user. I will get the choice of the user in our choice variable. Then I will say choice minus minus. Why I say choice minus minus? Let's say user want to mark the position number 9, but in the programming index start from 0. So if we mark position number 9, it means user actually wants to mark the position number 8 in the programming. So that's why I minus minus it, so it decreased by 1. Okay. Now here we will check a condition. So the condition will be, if choice is less than 0, if the choice is less than 0 or choice is greater than 8, then it means user have chosen an invalid choice. So we will print a message there. So we'll say please select your choice, please select your choice from, and here I will say 1 to 9. Now user will select choice from 1 to 9. After that, we need to check another condition. So we'll say else if, and here we'll check if board of choice is not equal to empty space. So we will check the same thing that we have checked for the computer choice. So here we are checking if the choice that user select, it's not empty. So if the position is not available, then we'll say cout please select an empty position. and inline. Okay, we will come down, and in the else we'll say board of choice. So if this condition gets false, it means user select the correct choice 100%. So we'll say board of choice equal to X, and then we will say break. It means it will break the loop. Okay, now this is how we get the choice for the X player. Now it will same for the O player. We just need to change one thing. So we'll copy this statement. I am using everything descriptively, but you can concise this code a lot better. But for the explanation, I am using everything in explained way. So what I will do, I just make it 0. It means get O player choice, and instead of X, I will say O. We just need to make this change there. Now we got the choice. Now let's implement the count board function. Now in the count board, it will count the symbol that we pass in the function, and it will count how many times it appears in the board. So it is int count board. It will accept a character symbol, and here what we will do, we will create a variable int total in which we store the total. Initially the total will be equal to 0. Here we'll run a for loop. We'll say for int I equal to 0, I less than 9, because the size of our board is 9. And here we'll say I plus plus. Here we'll say if board of I equal to the symbol that you pass, then what it will do, it will say total plus equal to 1. It will increase the total by 1. Okay, now after the for loop, we just return the total. So it will return the total to us. Okay, now we are clear from here. So till now, what we have done, we have created a main method. In main method, we are just showing the board. Then we have get computer choice, which will get the computer choice. Then we have get X player choice, which will get the choice for the X player. Then we have get O player choice, which will get the choice from O player. Then we have count board and show board. Okay, now let's create the function which is check winner. So this will return a character. So we'll say character check winner, and here we will open up this. Now first we will check row wise everything. So we'll check if the first row has the same character, that means this character won the game. So we'll say if, here we will say if board of 0 is equal to board of 1, and board of 1 is equal to board of 2. If board of 0 equal to board of 1 and board of 1 equal to board of 2, that means we have our winner. And we need to check another condition. What condition we need to check? We need to check another thing, and board of 0 not equal to empty. Because initially if we run the game, all the character are 0 or empty spaces. So this condition will get true because these are equal. So that's why we are checking the character should not be a space. Okay, now here if this condition gets true, so what we will do, we will say return board of 0. You can return any character among them. So we are checking first row, and we are also making sure that all the rows not have the empty space. So after that, I will copy this statement. I will paste it right here 2 times. So let me add a comment. I will say checking winner in horizontal or row. Okay, so we have checked for board of 0 to board of 2. Now we will start from board of 3. If board of 3 equal to board of 4, board of 4 equal to board of 5, and board of 3 is not equal to empty space. And then we will do the same thing for this one. We'll say board of 6 is equal to board of 7, board of 7 is equal to board of 8, and board of 6 is not equal to an empty space. Then we get the winner. So we are returning the first character. So you can return any character, because they will same. If they will same, only then this will return. So here we will return board of 3 and board of 6. Okay, now let's go down and check for checking winner in vertical or column. Okay, so here we will check the winner in vertically. Now to check the vertically, so we say that if board of 0 is equal to board of 3 and board of 3 is equal to board of 6 and board of 0 is not equal to an empty space, then return board of 0. So what I will do, I will copy this statement, paste it right here. Okay, now we just need to change the index number. So here we have checked for board of 0, board of 3 and board of 6. Here we check board of 1 is equal to board of 4 and board of 4 is equal to board of 7. And board of 1 is not equal to empty space. Okay, now here we will check if board of 2 is equal to board of 5. And board of 5 is equal to board of 8. Then we need to check another thing, which is board of 2 is not equal to empty space. Then what we'll return? We'll return board of 2, and here we'll return board of 1. Okay, now that's how we will check the horizontal and vertical. Now here we'll say checking winner in diagonal. So here we'll check the winner is diagonally. Okay, in the crosswise. So here what we will do, we'll say if board of 0 is equal to board of 4 and board of 4 is equal to board of 8 and board of 0 not equal to an empty space, then return board of 0. Okay, so here we are checking diagonally. Okay, now we need to check another diagonal. So here we'll say if board of 2 is equal to board of 4 and board of 4 is equal to board of 6 and board of 2 not equal to an empty space, then return board of 2. So we have checked all the things. We have checked horizontally, we have checked vertically, and we have checked diagonally. Now we have checked all these things. Here we need to check another thing. We need to check, is there any empty position that user can mark or the game is draw. So we'll check if. Now here we use our count board function. So we'll say if count board, and here we'll pass x, and we'll say if count board x plus count board o is less than 9, then what it will do, it will return c. It stands for continue. So we can assume that if it's return c, it means it says continue, else return d for draw. Okay, so whenever this function return d, it means the game is draw. So we have implemented our check winner function as well. Now it's time to implement our two last function, which is computer versus player game and player versus player. Now what I will do, I will implement them right here. So you can implement anywhere. So here we'll say void, and here we will call our computer versus player. Okay, so in the computer versus player, the first thing that we'll need, the string player name. Okay, so here we'll declare variable of string called player name. We will print out a message, enter your name. User will enter the name. We will store the name in player name variable. After that, we will run the loop for infinity time until we break it from inside. So here we'll say while true. So in the while block, what I will do, I will say system, and here I will say CLS. So it's not a recommended way to clear the screen, but it's work for the beginners. So you can use this. Okay, so after that, the first thing that I will do, I will first show the board. So I will call our show board function, which will show the board. After that, what I will do, I will check the condition. I will say if count board of x is equal to count board of o, then it's the turn of the player, because player will always be x. How this condition will work? Now see, if there is no position marked, it means they will be equal. It means x will be mark the first position. Okay, if x marks and then if o also marks, now these all x and o will be equal, then it's turn of x. So that's why whenever they equal, the turn will be assumed that the turn is for x. Okay, so now because it's a player choice, so we will print c out, and here we will print that player name, and here we'll say player names turn, so player can understand that it's my turn. And inline, after that we will use our get x player function, which will get x player choice function, which will get the choice for the x player. I will come down, and in the else I will say else get computer choice. So if it's not a player choice, it will get the choice for the computer. So we will come down, we will create a character variable, and we'll name this character variable as winner, and we will call our check winner function. Now whatever check winner will return, it will store in our winner variable. Now what I will do here, I will say if winner equals to x, then what it will do, it will go down, it will say system cls. It will first clear the screen, and here it will show the board, the final board, and after that we will print c out, and here we'll say player name won the game. Okay, so after that we will say break, because if anyone wins the game, it should break. Now we will check another condition, which is else if. Here we'll check else if winner is equal to o, it means computer wins. So here we'll say system cls show board, and here we'll say c out computer won the game. So I will make them in the double quotes because it's a text. I will end the line. Okay, now we have checked for computer and player. Now let's check for a draw. So I will check else if winner is equal to d. If the check winner function return d, it means the game is draw. So here we'll say c out game is draw. Okay, and here we will print the inline and break. Okay, another thing is that we need to break this right here as well, because whenever anyone wins, it will break. So that's all for this. Now let's play the game and let's see is it working or not. So what I will do, I will call the computer versus player function right there. I will run this code and see is it working or not, and it's working. So I will enter my name Abdullah, so it says this thing, but there are two positions that are already marked. I will add the spaces, so we have now an empty board. Okay, I will say my name is Abdullah. Here it will show the empty board. So first of all, I will mark this first position, and it says please select an empty position. So we have done a mistake. What we have did, we didn't close the square bracket right here, so that was our mistake, and the same mistake will be right here as well. So we need to solve this. Now I will run this code again, and hopefully this will work fine. Now I will say Abdullah, and I will mark the first place. Okay, you can see I will mark this place and computer marks this place. So this time I will mark the place number 9. Computer marks this place. Now this time I will mark the place number 5. Now it says Abdullah won the game because I have consecutive X in my diagonal. Okay, so it's working fine. Now let's go down and implement the function, which is player versus player game. So two players can also play this game. Now to implement the player versus player game, what we will do, almost the logic will be same as above, but we need to make some changes right there. First I will say void player versus player, and here the first thing that we will do, we will create string variables. So here we'll say X player name, because now we will have two players name and O player name. So we have X player name and O player name. After that, what I will do, I will print a message cout enter X player name. Whoever enter the first name, the sign of the player will be X. Okay, then we will store the name in our X player name variable. After that we will print another cout message enter O player name, and I will store it in O player name variable. Now we have got our names out there. Now we will do the same thing, we will run a while loop, and here I will say while true, because we want to break it from the inside. First thing they will do, will clear the screen. So we'll say system CLS. After that, what I will do, I will show the board so user can see the board. So I will say show board, and here we'll check the same condition. So we'll say if count board of X, if count board of X is equal to count board of O, then what it will do, it will get the choice for the X. So here what I will do, I will say get the choice for X. So first of all I will print cout, we'll print the name of the X player, and here we'll say X player's turn, so user can understand which turns is it. After that, after printing the turn, we'll call our get X player function, so it will get the choice. So the function name is get X player choice. Okay, now we will go down in the else part. So in the else we will say the same thing, we will say cout O player name, O player name's turn, and here we will say inline. After that we will call our get O player choice function. Okay, so after that what we will do, we will do the same thing. So we'll say character winner is equal to check winner. So here I will check if the winner is equal to the X, it means X won the game. So here we will come down, we'll say system CLS. After that we will show the board. After showing the board, what I will say, I will say cout X player name, X player name won the game. Okay, after that I will say break, because if anyone won the game it should break. I will say else if winner is equal to O, we'll do the same thing. So we'll say system CLS, show the board so user can see the results. After that we'll say cout O player name won the game, and inline and break. Now after that we'll check the draw. So here we'll say else if winner is equal to D, if the result is equal to D, it means it's a draw. Here we'll say cout game is draw. Okay, and inline. After the draw we will also print the break.
Now that's all that we need to do for player versus player function. Now we will go in the main function. Now in the main function, we just need to add a simple switch condition. So our main function can check that whether user want to play the player versus player mode or computer versus player mode. Okay. So now for that, I will declare a variable. I will say int mode in which we get the mode. So here I will print two choice for the user. I will say one is computer versus player and inline, and we have a second choice as well, which is player versus player, okay, and inline. So we have two choices out there. Now we will ask the user to select the game mode. So we'll say select game mode inline. We will store the game mode in our game mode variable. So here we'll say mode. Now we will use the switch statement. So we'll say switch mode. Now we will come down, and here we will say case. If case is 1, then what we will do? In the case 1, we will call our computer versus player function. So user want to play the game with the computer. After that, I will say break. And in the case 2, we will call player versus player function, because two players want to play the game, break. After that, in the default, I will say default cout. I will print a message if user doesn't select 1 and 2. So I will say please select valid game mode. So I will say please select valid game mode and inline. After that, we can say here break, or if you don't say, it's totally okay. That's all that we need to do. Now let's run our game and see how our game works. So first of all, it is asking computer versus player mode or player versus player mode. So let's try the first mode first. So I will say computer versus player mode. So it will ask for my name. I will add Abdullah there. So we have launched our game. So now here I will mark a position. So 1, and then I will mark 2, and let's try to mark the same position that already marked. So let's say I want to mark the position number 2. So it will say please select an empty position. And if I say 11, this is not a valid position. So it will say please select your choice from 1 to 9. Okay. So I will say 3, and it says Abdullah won the game because I have consecutive 3 X signs on the first row. So that's how our computer versus player will work. Now let's try the player versus player game. So I will say 2. So I will enter the name is Abdullah, and the second name is Puarasan. So here, so it says Abdullah's turn. So I will say 1. Now it's Puarasan's turn. So I will say 2. So it's say Abdullah's turn. I will say 3. It's Puarasan's turn. So I will say 5. Again, it's Abdullah's turn. So I will say 6 there. And Puarasan's turn, I will say 8. So it says Puarasan won the game. So that's how our game program will work. So that's how we can create tic-tac-toe game in which we have two modes, a computer versus player mode and player versus player mode. And the user can decide whether it's want to play the game with the computer or whether it's want to play the game with his friend. So that's how we can create this game. Now I have a little assignment for you. So I want you to add another feature in this game. Now the feature will be like this. First, you will ask the game mode from the user. So user will select either computer versus player or player versus player. And then you will ask how many rounds you want to play. So if user says I want to play 5 rounds, then you will play the game for 5 times. Okay. So let's say computer won 2 game and user won 1 game and 2 games are draw. Then you will also display the result that computer won the game and how many rounds computer won? Computer won 2 rounds and player won 1 round. So you will print the result as well. Okay.
So now you can do this thing with the help of a variable. So you can store rounds in your round variable. Then you can run a while loop or for loop, which will run rounds time. And then you can create variables like computer score and player score, in which you store the score of computer and player. That's how you can do this assignment. I highly recommend you to, after doing this assignment, comment down your answer below in the comment section below, so I can see your answer and I can see how much interest do you have in C++ programming.
Welcome back everyone, my name is Abdullah Ghori from Alpha Technology, and in this video we will create Kaun Banega Crorepati game in C++ programming. So let me show you that how our game will look like. So this is the final output of our game. So first we need to enter our name. So let's say I will say Abdullah Ghori. If I hit enter, I will see these rules and regulation for the game. So the first rule is that there are total 10 questions in this game. There are only 2 lifelines which you can use at any stage of the game. The first lifeline is pay half and skip, means you have to pay 1/4 of current question price. There is another lifeline which is leave question. It means you can leave a question without any deduction. So you don't need to pay anything when you have leave question lifeline. So if you attempt 3 consecutive right answer, pay half and skip will be recovered. So whenever you use pay half and skip lifeline, so this lifeline will be gone. And whenever you attempt 3 consecutive right answer, then this lifeline will be rescued. And the same goes for leave question. If you use this leave question lifeline, then you will lost your leave question lifeline, but you can get it back by attempting 5 consecutive right answer. After every question, the amount of question will be double. So let's say the first question amount is $100, so in the second question amount will be $200. If the answer is wrong, half amount of the question price deducted from your balance. Press H for play half and skip help line, and press L for leave question help line. Press A, B, C or D to answer any question. Press any key to get start. Let's press any key to get start. So you can see that it is saying this is question number 1 is for $100 and our balance is 0 for now. We have 2 lifelines, pay half and skip and leave the question. So this is our question. The name of the structure is referenced to as its. So the correct answer is data type. So we'll say D. So you can see it will print a message that congratulations, your answer is correct or right. You earn $100. Press any key to continue. Now you can see we got $100 in our balance. And we got, now the second question amount is double. So first we have $100, now it's double and it's become $200. We have 2 lifelines. Let's say what if we enter any wrong answer. Let's say, so the process of sending an argument to the function is called, let's say sending. So we have attempt a wrong answer there. Okay, so that's why we lose our $100 and price is doubled. So because previously the price was $200, now it become $400. Let's try to use our helpline. So we can use our leave question helpline. So it says you choose the lifeline leave question, you lose $0. So we can leave this question. Now you can see we have lost our leave question lifeline. So we can use H. So for this time we need to pay the 1/4 of the question price. Like if we have $400, then we need to pay $200. Now if I enter, you will see that our balance is minus $400. Now let's try to give correct answer and see whether we are getting back our lifelines or not. So for this we'll say A, which is correct answer, and we earn $1600. Now our balance become $1200 because we have the balance is minus $400. Two dimensional array can be viewed as rows and columns, so we'll say B, and here A. Now we attempt 3 consecutive right question and you can see we got pay half and skip back. So let's try to attempt more right questions, and let's see. So we attempt 5 questions, right? So we can see that, you can see that we got our 2 lifeline back. So we can use any lifeline again. And now this will be our report card. So it will say player name Abdullah, right answer 6, wrong answer 1, and average is 60%, and winning amount is $49,200. So that's how our game will look like. So without any wasting time, what I want to show you, I want to show you that on my channel Alpha Technology, I am continuously uploading C++ programming tutorials, so you can watch and learn C++ programming for free. Do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so you get notification about all the upcoming videos. So without any wasting time, let's create our game. So first of all, we will click on create a new project, then we will click console screen and next, and C++ selected, and here we will say game project, and we will click on next and finish. So we got our game project. So we will open up our main file. So this is the basic code that code blocks provide us. So now let me zoom it. I think this is enough for you. Now first of all, we want to set some variables there. The first thing is that I don't want this code, so I will remove this thing. So after using namespace std, we will start creating our global variables. So the first global variable will be a string player name, so in which we store the name of the player. After that, we will create a boolean variable which will be our lifeline. So we'll say pay half and skip. So this is our lifeline. Initially the lifeline will be equal to true, and we will create another lifeline which is skip, and which will also equal to true. And after that, we will create a long variable, so we'll say long, and here we will name this cache. So this will be the cache amount that we have. So initially it will be equal to 0. After that, we will create another long variable which is question price. So here we'll say question price. Initially the question price will be $100. After that, we need to create another variable in which we store the consecutive question attempt. So here we'll say consecutive is equal to 0. Initially our right consecutive questions will be equal to 0. So we need to create 2 more variables, int right answer, and after that we will say int wrong answer, and we make it equal to 0, and we will make it equal to 0 as well. So these are the variables that we need to create. But after that, we need to define some methods like void, and first method will be results. So we will implement our results method, which will show the result at the end of our game. After that, we will create another function which will be our game rules, in which we will define our game rules. After that, we will create another function which is ask random question. So we'll say void ask random question. So this function will ask random question from the user. After that, we need to create our last function which is check answer. This function will take 2 arguments, character answer which user give. The second argument will be character correct answer that we have stored. After that, we will create a structure. So here we'll say struct, and we'll name this structure as question. So we are creating a question structure there. So here we will add some data members. So we'll say string question. So in this variable, we will store our question. After that, I will say string option A. So we'll say option A, and I will copy and paste this thing, and I will say option B, option C, and option D. In these variables, we will store our options. After that, I will say character answer. In this, we will store the correct answer of the question. After that, we need to create another variable, which is Boolean availability, in which we store the availability of the question. So whenever we ask any question, we'll make it unavailable. So it will make sure that we will not ask same question again and again. Okay, now let's move on. Now let's create a questions array. So here we'll say questions, and we want to create 10 questions for now. So I am creating an array of question structure. The size of the array is 10. After that, we will go in our main method, and here to clear the screen I use system, and here I will pass CLS. So this is not a recommended method to clear the screen, but for the beginners it's work. After that, I will set my all the question. So how do we set this? So we'll say question. So questions of 0 is equal to, so we will assign our this array. So we will assign all the values like question of 0, question of 1, question of 2, and so on. So we need to assign all the question as well, and the options, and the correct option, and the availability. So how do we do that? Let's assign the first question. So how do we add a first question? So we'll say let's add which programming structure, which programming structure makes a comparison. So this is our first question. Now what I will do, I will put a comma. So after that, after question, you can see here we have option A. So we will put our option A. So I will say here relation. The first option is relation. The second option is decision. The third option is sequence. And the fourth option will be repetition. After that, we need to provide the correct answer. So in this case, decision is the correct answer. So we'll say there B. So in single quote, because our correct answer, you can see here, our correct answer is a character. So we need to provide it in a single quotes. After that, we will make the availability as true. So that's how we need to add all the questions. So let me zoom it out. And that's how you will add all the questions. So I will not waste your time. I will add all the questions by myself, and I will pause this video for a minute, and then we will move on. So I have write down all the questions, and now we are good to go to move on. So there are some mistakes because I type it very quickly. Okay, so I have typed 10 questions for our program, and I have provided the option A, B, C, and D, and then I have provided the correct option. So if A is correct, then you need to provide A, and then you need to set them all as true. The other alternative is that you can make it availability true by here. So you don't need to make it true here. Okay, so now let's move on to our next step. After that, what we will do, we will print a cout statement. So here we'll say cout, and here we will add a whole equal line. After that, I will say inline there. After that, we can copy this thing and paste it right here 4 times. Okay, so I want to write a welcome message there. So I will say welcome to the, and after that I will erase some equal signs, and here I will say welcome to the Kaun Banega Crorepati game show. So this will be the our text. So I will make them equal. Okay, so this is our welcome text. After that, we want to get the input from the user. So here I will say cout. I will say enter your name. User will enter his name. After that, we will use getLine method, because maybe user enter his full name, so we'll use getLine. So we'll say cin, and we want to get the input in our player name variable. So if you not familiar about getLine, you can watch my tutorial. I have a separate video on getLine, so you can watch this thing from there. After that, I will say system, and I will put CLS there to clear the screen. Again, this is a not recommended way, but you can use this way as well. So after that, I will call our game rules function. Okay, so after that, we want to create a while loop. So we'll say while, and in the parentheses of while, I will say true. It will the while loop will run until we not break it inside. So here we'll say if question. So we need to create a variable called question number. So we will go at the top. So we will make our question number equal to 1, and we will go down and we'll say if the question number is greater than 10, then break the while loop. That means we have asked all the 10 questions that are available in our program. So after that, what we want to do, if the question are not asked, so what I will do, I will call our ask random question function. So that's all we need to do here. After that, we just want to print our results there. Okay, so that's all for the main method or main function. Let's go down and create our other methods. So first of all, I will create void ask random question method or function. Here I will say the srand. So for the srand, we need to go at the top and we need to include some header file. So the first header file is ctime, and the other header file is conio.h. So we need to include these two header files, and here we will go down, and here we will pass time, and at the time we will pass 0. So it will set a random number for us. After that, we will use a while loop. So we'll say while, and here we will make it true. Now we will go down. So here we will create the screen using system CLS. After that, we will create an int number variable in which we store our random number. So how do we generate a random number? If you don't know, you can watch my tutorial. I have a separate video on random number generator. So here we'll say int number is equal to rand percentage 10. So it will give us a random number from 0 to 9. After that, we will use a if condition. So here we'll say if questions of number, so we will pass our number in the questions array dot availability. So it will check that if the availability is true, it will come inside this if block. If the availability is true, then we will go in the block of if, and here the first thing that we will do, we will set the questions of number dot availability is false. So the first thing is that we will make this availability is false, so we will not ask this question again. After that, what I will do, I will go at the top, I will copy this, I will paste it right here to make the output look pretty good. I will go up again, so you can make it more beautiful by spending more time on aligning them in a good order, but I will do only this thing. So after that, what I will do, I will say that cout, and I will print a n line. So after that, what we will do, we will print the front screen. So we'll say this question number. So here we need to print the question number. So how do we print the question number? So we use our question number variable. So here we'll say question number, and after that we'll say is for, and here we'll say dollar sign, and after that we need to print the price of the question. So here we'll say question price. After that we will add some slash t there for adding tab. So we will add 4 slash t. It means it will add 4 tabs to our text. After that we will print the balance. We'll say balance is dollar, and here we will print the cash. And after that we will say inline and inline. So we will print 2 inlines there. After that we will come down and we'll say cout, and here we will print the lifeline. So here we'll say life lines. After that we will come down, and now we need to check the condition. So we want to make our program dynamic, so we'll check the condition. If the lifeline is available, only then we will print that you can use the lifeline. So we'll say if pay half and skip, if it's true then it's come down. So here we'll say cout, and here we will print a slash t first, and then we'll say h for pay half and skip. Okay, so after that we'll check another condition. So we'll say if skip is true, then we will come down again, and here we will print a slash t, and then we can say l, press l for leave question. And after that we will go down, and here we will print 2 and line. So this is just for making the code in a good alignment, in a proper looking way. So now I will copy this line, I will copy this line and paste the line here. After that I will paste it again, and I will go here and I will say that choose your option. So we'll say this thing, user will choose his option. So after that, so what we will do, we will print the options. So here we will say cout, we'll say questions of number dot. Now here what we will need to do, we need to print the question. So here we'll say question. After that we'll print 2 and line. So we'll say inline and inline. Okay, after that we will go down and we will print the option A. So we'll say A, and after that here we will say questions of number dot option A. After printing the option A, I want to put a space there, so I will say slash t 2 times, and for the option B I will say that questions of number. Why we are using number again and again? Because this number we got from the random number generator. So this is the question number, so it will select any question from this, so we are using that number. So we don't know, because this will be selected by dynamic number. So here we will print option B as well. After that we will print 2 and line. So here we'll say option B. One second. Option B and inline, inline. After that we will come down, we will say C out, and for the C I will say that question of number dot option C, and after that I will put slash t same as above. So I will put 2 slash t and then option D. After that we will say questions of number dot option D. Okay, and inline and inline. So that's for the options. Now we will create a character variable. So we'll say character and here we'll name this answer, and which will be equal to underscore getCHE. So this getCHE will get a character and it will print the character as well, okay. And why we are using getCHE? Because if we use cin, then user need to press enter key. So we don't want to user press enter key. We just want whenever user print press any key, it will print the appropriate message. Like if the answer is right, it will print right. Otherwise, it will say your answer is wrong. So after that, we will say answer is equal to 2 lower. We will convert our answer in the lower case. So here we'll say answer. So it will convert our answer into lower case. So we don't need to check with the uppercase and lower case again and again. So after that we'll say inline. And after that we will say that question number plus plus. So it will increase the number of question. After that we will call our check answer function. And here we will provide the answer that user give to us, and we need to provide the correct answer. So in this case, our correct answer will be in questions of number dot answer. So this will be our correct answer. So that's all that we need to do, and at the last we will say break. So for this function, that's all that we need to do. Now we will go down, we will create another function which is our check answer. So here we'll say check answer, and here we will say character answer, and we will create another character argument which is correct answer. We'll come down. Now we need to check some condition. We'll say that if answer is equal to correct answer, then we'll come down. If the answer is correct, equal to the correct answer, then we will print a message: congratulations, you answer, your answer, we'll say congratulations, your answer is right. After that we will print an inline. We will print another message that you earned, so we'll say you earned dollar, and here we will print the question price and inline. After that what we will say, we will say cout. Here we'll say press any key to continue and inline. So here we only say getCH. So here we'll not say getCHE because it will not print anything, it just get the character and then it will go and run again. After that we will say right answer plus plus because the user has attempt a right answer, and we'll add a consecutive answer in our consecutive variable. And after that we need to update the cache as well. So we say cache is equal to cache plus question price. So we will add the question price in our cache variable. So after that we will need to check another condition. So maybe user select the lifeline. So here we'll say if answer is equal to H. So if user select H, that means he want to use his lifeline. And we need to check another thing. We need to make sure that if he has the lifeline option available or not. We'll say that pay half and skip. If this is available, it means it's true, and this condition will be true. So here we'll say cout, and here we'll say you choose the lifeline. You choose the lifeline, and here we'll name our lifeline pay half and skip. So user has chosen the lifeline pay half and skip. After printing that, we say that cout, you lose dollar, because If he slept pay half and skip lifeline, he will use question price divided by 4. So it will, he will use the 1/4 of the question price. So that's how we will calculate the 1/4 of the question price. After that, we will say this thing again. So we will copy this thing and we will print this thing here. So that's all for the pay half and skip lifeline. And at the end, what we need to do, we need to make this pay half and skip lifeline is false. So the first thing is that we need to update the cache. So here we'll say cache is equal to cache minus, and here we will calculate the 1/4. So here we'll say question price divided by 4. After that, we will say pay half and skip is equal to false. So we will make this false. We'll come down and we'll check the lifeline for leave question. So here we'll say if the answer is equal to L, it means user want to use his leave question lifeline, but we want to make sure that is he available, is he has the leave question lifeline. So we'll check if he has skip lifeline, then he can use this. And here we will print a message that cout you choose the lifeline leave question. Okay, and then we'll print an end line there. After that, we will say cout you lose $0. So because for the leave question we don't have any deduction, so that's why we will not say anything. We'll say you lose $0. And here we will print the same thing, press any key to continue. After that, we will update our cache. So we don't need to update our cache actually, we just need to say skip is equal to false because he has used this lifeline. After that, we will go in the else part. So here we'll say else. Now what we will say, we will say cout. Else means user has attempted a wrong answer. So for this thing, we'll say sorry, your answer is wrong. So here we'll say your answer is wrong. And after that, we will say that cout you lose $, and here we'll say question price divided by 2. So he will lose the half of the question price. After that, we will press the same press any key to continue. After that, we will say wrong answer plus plus, it will add a wrong answer. And we will set our consecutive is equal to 0, because if user answer attempt a wrong answer, that means he lost his consecutiveness. And after that, we will say cache is equal to cache minus, and here we will say question price divided by 2. So it will minus the half of the question price from his cache. After that, we will go down and we will increase the question price. So here we will say question price is equal to question price multiplied by 2. After that, we will check two conditions more. So we'll check if consecutive is equal to 3, then he need to make sure that pay half and skip is available. So we'll say pay half and skip is equal to true. So we'll make it true if user attempt 3 consecutive right answer. So we'll check another condition, if consecutive is equal to 5, then that means he got his leave question lifeline back. So we'll say skip is equal to true. So that's all for the check answer function. Now we will go down, and here we will create our result function. So here we'll say void results, and here we will print the result. So here first we'll say double percentage to calculate the percentage, and here we'll say percentage is equal to right answer multiply by 10. Okay, after that we'll say system cls to clear this screen. Again, this is not a recommended way. After that I will go at the top, I will copy this line because I want to paste this thing here, and after that I will paste it again. So I need 3. So here I will go at the middle and I will say results. After that I will go down, I will say cout, and here I will print the player name. So I will say player name, so whatever the player name, but I will print 3/t. After that I will say player name and inline and inline. So I will put 2 inline there. After that I will say that write answers, and here I will say /t/t and /t, and here I will call our write answer variable, and I will put 2 inline there. After that we will print the wrong answer, so here we'll say wrong answers, and here we need to put 3/t to make it in proper order, and here we will call wrong answer variable and inline. After that we want to print the average, so we'll say cout average, and here we will put 3/t again. After that we will say percentage, and here we will put a percentage sign. After that we will say inline and inline. Okay, now we will go down. Now we need to check a if condition, so we'll say if cache is greater than or equal to 0, then it will say cout, and here it will say winning amount /t/t/t, and here I will put dollar sign, and here I will say cache, and after that I need to say inline and inline again. So at the else part I will say cout losing amount /t/t/t and dollar sign and cache inline and inline. Okay, after that I will put this line there, I will say this thing again, this line and this line. So you can print any message, like I will put here, I will say thanks for playing this game. Okay, so we will add a message that thanks for playing this game. After that we will say that tutorial by Alpha Technology, and here we will put some equal signs, and here also, and after that we will say equal sign, and we will put 2 equal signs right there. Okay, so after that what I want to do, I want to say here press any key to continue, so I will put this thing, and at the end I will go there, I will put a space, one space there, at the end I will say get ch. So after that we need to create our last method, which will be game rules. So here we'll create the method called game rules, and here I will type all the game rules. So I am pausing the video so it will not waste your time. So I have write down all the game rules right there, so you can see. Now we are good to go to run our program. So let's see how our game works. So we got an error. So here it's not count, it's C out. Let's run it again, because this is a huge program, so it's okay to have errors like get ch. I think that we have made a lot of get ch. Sorry, you need to change the get wch to get ch. Now our program is running, so let's print, let's put my name. So I will say Abdullah Ghori. If I enter, I will see all the game rules right there. If I press enter again, I will see this question, and it is in a good format. So let's try to run, let's try to play the game. So first of all, I want to attempt a right question, so I will say A. So it say congratulations, your answer is right and you earn $100. So I'll press enter. So you can see I got $100 in my balance, and the amount of question is doubled. Now I want to give a wrong answer, so if I say A, so it says sorry, your answer is wrong and you lose 100. So because the price of the question is 200, so I lose the half amount of the question. So if I press space or any key, so my balance becomes zero because I have lose the $100 that I have earned. So now what I will do, I will use my leave question lifeline. So it says you choose the lifeline leave question, you lose $0. Let's say press enter, so our leave question lifeline is no longer there. Let's try to use our pay half and skip lifeline. So you can see if I press H, so it says you choose the lifeline, pay half and skip, you lose $200. If I press enter again, so I have minus 200 in my balance. Now let's try to put and let's try to give consecutive right answer. So here I will say B, so it's a good and correct answer. So for this thing I will say D, and here I will say B. So I got pay half and skip back because I have attempt three consecutive right answer. So for this thing I will say D, and for this thing I will say B. So I have attempt five consecutive right answer, so I got my two helpline back. Now I can use the helpline, but I don't want to use them for now. I will say C. Oh, I have attempt a wrong answer. So you can see I have attempt two wrong answer. I have used two lifelines, and right answer is 6, and the average is 60%, and I have earned $23,800. So that's all for this video. Hope you enjoy this video. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you have any question regarding this video, you can comment down below. If you want more videos like that, you can subscribe our channel. I will upload more video and more good content like this in future as well. So make sure to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon, so you will get notification about all the upcoming videos. So I will upload complete C++ programming tutorials on this channel. Please stay tuned and help us by liking this video, and if you have any query, you can comment down below. Or if you really enjoy this video, you can comment, you can write a good comment for us, and it will encourage us to make more good content for you. Thanks a lot for watching this video.